With joy we come before God as we begin our celebration in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
By the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good evening to you all. And I welcome you today to today's celebration. On this day, the first Sunday of Advent, when the Lord calls us to repentance, when he speaks to us to be ready, to prepare ourselves. But above all, the Lord reminds us today of the freedom he has given to us on earth as his children. He prompts us through his Spirit to work very hard so that our lives here on earth may give him praise. So that when we finish our lives here on earth, we might join him in heaven to glorify him. Let us, my brothers and sisters, listen to the words of the Spirit, that we may bear fruit and abundantly through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
At this Mass, we pray for
the repose of the soul of Melanie Melanson.
My brothers and sisters, we are sinners and in need of God's grace. Let us therefore take a moment to recall the times we have failed God and failed man. Let us be sorry for those times and humbly ask God for his pardon and peace. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant you are faithful, we pray, Almighty God, the resolve to run forth to meet your Christ with righteous deeds as his coming, so that gathered at his right hand, we may be worthy to possess the heavenly kingdom through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Proclamation from the book of the prophet Isaiah. You, Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer, you are named forever. Why do you let us wander, O Lord, from your ways, and harden our hearts so we fear you not? Return for the sake of your servants, the tribes of your heritage. Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down, with the mountains quaking before you. While you wrought awesome deeds we could not hope for, such as they had not heard of from of old. No ear has ever heard, no eye ever seen, any God but you doing such deeds for those who wait for him. Would that you might meet us doing right, that we were mindful of you in our ways. Behold, you are angry, and we are sinful. All of us have become like unclean people. All our good deeds are like polluted rags. We have all withered like leaves, and our guilt carries us away like the wind. There is none who calls upon your name, who rouses himself to cling to you. For you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us up to our guilt. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you the potter. We are all the work of your hands. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always on your account for the grace of God bestowed on you in Christ Jesus, that in him you are enriched in every way with all discourse and testimony, as the testimony to Christ was confirmed among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revelation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will keep you firm to the end, irreproachable on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful, and by him you are called to fellowship with his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said to his disciples, be watchful, be alert, You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his own work, and orders a gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore, you do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all, watch the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening to you all.
Amen.
My prayer is that the Lord may not come and find us wanting through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Are you sleeping? I think it is too cold, right?
No.
I said, my prayer is that the Lord, that when the Lord comes, he may not find us wanting through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
What were you waiting for the first time? Amen.
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 Amen. You know, the church has asked us in the Second Vatican Council, Sacrosanctum Concilium, it asked us to be participatory. Are you with me?
Yes.
The time was has gone when it was the priest church. It will face the Vatican I, face the altar and finish up everything. Now, we all participate and we give our worship together to God. And it means, when I speak, I am speaking. And then when it is your turn to speak, you speak. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. When it's your turn to respond, you respond. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Now you're responding. That's good. Today is the first Sunday of Advent. When we begin the time of soul searching, when we begin to look into ourselves, beginning from January until today, to ask ourselves, how much have we prepared for the Lord's coming? It is not just all about Christmas, but all about what? The preparation we have made. How much have we defended our Christian faith? How wayward have we been? This is a time of reckoning. A time when we go into prayer for two things. Either to thank God for how we have lived our lives, or to be sorry for the mistakes we have made. And to go into prayer and fasting. To go into self-denial of material things and whatever that leads us to sin and separates us from God. The first reading of today, Isaiah chapter number 63. The prophet looked around and he saw the sinful nature of man redeemed by God. And he felt very sorry. He felt very bad. Now the question is, if the Lord comes in here and looks at you, do you think he will be happy? Do you think he will be sad of heart? Isaiah the prophet looked at the lives of the people. They became egocentric. They lost the sight of God. They began to worship other gods. They took to sin. And he began to beckon on God. God, come down. Come down in your might and bring us back to the fold. Come down and shepherd us. Come down and revive us. Today, the Lord is reminding us, my brothers and sisters, that he has come to revive us. He is calling us together for a time of sober reflection, a time of stock-taking, a time of asking ourselves, how much faithful have I been? How much determined have I been? You know, sometimes in our life, I get some questions and You know, it's not everything I can answer. I hope you understand. That I'm a priest doesn't mean I know everything, right? No, I don't know everything. No, I don't. If others do, I don't. But there are some questions that some faithful will ask you. God, Father, why does God allow this evil to happen? Then sometimes I look at them in the face and I say, when you ask me, who should I ask? But there is always a purpose for everything. When man goes wrong, God brings him back. God is always out to resettle us. As we have begun the period of Advent, Christ is calling on us to prepare his way. He is not asking us to build a freeway, no. But he's asking us to prepare our hearts for his coming. To ask ourselves, all this while, in our souls, will he have a befitting place to live in when he comes? When the Lord comes, will he freely live in your heart and be satisfied? This is the time to begin to prepare. This is a time to determine within yourself, do I want to meet God? What does Christmas mean for me? The coming of Christ. Is it all about changing the things I have, buying new things? Yes, they are so wonderful. But the Lord would want you to, not to buy a new heart, but to prepare your heart, to wash it clean. So that when he comes, there will be a befitting place for him to stay. One thing about life is this, no one knows when the Lord will come. And as such, we all ought to be ready at all times. We all have to come back to God. That is the desire of God. That is what God is beckoning on us. And that is why we have this time. A time to look into ourselves, see where we are. Are we on the left side? Can we move to the right? Are we on the right? How firm are we on that right? Isaiah beckoned on God to come. Lord, please come down. Do wonderful things in our lives. God comes down every day and does the wonderful things. But are we always determined to remain within that faithfulness of God? This is a time to come back. This is a time to return to the Lord. The prophet Hosea, in Hosea chapter number 6, when he begins from number 1, he beckons us. He says, let us return to the Lord our God. Who has a Bible? I want you to listen. This is a time of prophetic words. When the Lord reminds us what to do, the prophet Hosea, who has a Bible? Who has a Bible? Yes, beg us. Hosea, the prophet Hosea. Yes. Just get down, Jeremiah, get down to Daniel, you see Hosea? Yes, one of the minor prophets. Chapter number 6, begin from verse number 1. The Lord tells us at this point to come back to him. But then there are greater things waiting for us when we go to the Lord. There is revival, there is restoration, there is hope. What does he say? No. The prophet Hosea, chapter number 6. I know I have heard it, O poor priest.
In their affliction, they shall look for me.
No. Chapter number 6.
Chapter 6.
Hosea. Yeah. No. Go on, let me see what it has. Go on. Yes. Go on, let's see.
Come, let us return to the Lord.
Now you are talking. Come, let us return to the Lord. I know what he says. Amen.
Amen.
My Bible is here. It is not cracked. There is no virus. Yes.
Okay. For it is he who has rent.
For he has rented us.
But he will heal.
He said he will. Now listen. Hold on. God is ready to heal us. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Do you think you are destroyed? Do you think you have gone astray, man? Rodriguez.
Yeah.
The Lord says, I will heal you. God says he will heal each and every one of us. All we need to do is to do what? To come back to him for that healing. This is a time of that healing. This is that time of restoration. This is that time of renewal. God is beckoning on you to come back to salvation. What is it that is holding you down? Listen to the word of God.
He has struck us.
He has struck us.
But he will bind
us together. He will bind our wounds. Go on.
He will revive us after 2 days.
God says it's just for a time and he will revive you.
On the third day he will raise us up.
He says he will raise us up.
To live in his presence.
To live in God's presence. Who wants to live in God's presence? Now, yes, every one of us wants to live in God's presence. And the Lord is asking you to do what? Begin again from that number one. What he has asked us to do. Return.
Come, let us return to the Lord.
Come is an invitation. An invitation from the prophet. God is asking us to come. Let us do what? Return to our God. It takes determination. And this period of Advent, a time when we, with sorrow in our hearts, seek God. A time when we, God's children, remember how unfaithful we have been and begin to prepare a place, a befitting place for the Lord. Remember the book of Revelations reminds us. It says, I am at the door of your heart and I am knocking. If anyone opens up his heart or her heart, I will come in. This is the time of opening. This is a time of silent listening. To listen to the word of God. To listen to the promptings of the Spirit in our hearts. My brothers and sisters, there is joy in the Lord.
Amen.
There is joy in the Lord. And that is the joy he is offering us at this moment. Reviving us. Giving us a befitting place in his kingdom. God calls us each time. You know, there are some parts of the Bible that when you read, you don't just see the faithfulness of God, but you see God's love. You see the opportunities opening up for all who trust in God. The God of mercy, the God of love. The book of Psalms, chapter number 37. Open up, Elizabeth. Yes, Psalms 37, verse number 27. Let's see. God beckons on us at each moment. Who again has a Bible here?
37.
Vanessa, yes. Who again?
37, 27.
Yes. Read verse number 27.
Turn your back on evil and do
good. Turn your back on evil and do what?
Do good.
And do good. God is asking us. This is a time of preparation. Part of our preparation is to do what? To turn our back on evil and do good. You cannot tell me you are preparing, but then every night you get drunk and you go to sleep. God, you know I'm struggling. You are not struggling. Are you with me? Are you with me?
Yes.
We need to struggle to say no to sin. James chapter number 4 tells us the same thing. Shun the devil and he will run away from you. This period of Advent is a time of inward reflection to bring about the best in us. Are you ready for that best? What does it say, Elizabeth?
In Psalms?
Yes. Keep on.
Okay. For you will have a home forever.
For you will have a home forever. He says, turn your back on evil and do good, and you will have a home for yourself forever in God. So when we, my brothers and sisters, when we turn our back on evil, when we turn our back from hatred, from racial discrimination, from jealousy, from lack of prayer, from every evil, when we ask ourselves, look, life is all about God. Remember the word of God. Seek ye the kingdom of God, and every other thing will be added. Am I right?
Yes.
This is that time to seek the kingdom of God. He says, turn your back on evil and do good. What is that evil tying you down like a rock? What is that evil? What is that sin? What is that malice? What is that block tying you down and sinking you into sin, drowning you in a pool of sadness? God is asking you today to turn away from evil and do good. so that you will have a home forever with him in heaven. The sole purpose of our creation, God tells us in our catechism, to know God, to love him, to serve him, so that we will live with him forever in heaven. This is the time of what? Of that preparation to get to heaven. The Lord calls us at this moment not to procrastinate. That sometimes we think we do not have the power. No, St. Paul, in writing to the Corinthians, we read this afternoon, he says, God has given us his spirit that we will have nothing to lack, that we might be firm at the coming of our Lord, that we might be irreproachable. I want you to listen to the word of God. God uses his words to strengthen us, to give us hope. God says, with his spirit in us, we shall become what? Irreproachable. Do you understand that? Yes. It means we will have no stain. No one can accuse us of anything. No one can chastise us that we might be plain. And it is only the word of God that sanctifies us. St. Paul makes us happy today, my brothers and sisters. Are you sad of heart? St. Paul reminds you, God has put his spirit in you. He says you are irreproachable. Do people weigh you down by what they say and how they react to you? Are the things happening around weighing you down? God is asking you to stand up. Isaiah chapter number 6, he says, arise and shine. This is the time for us to arise. God promises us that with his spirit in us, we have been empowered. With his spirit in us, we have been sanctified and will have nothing to worry. And that's why he has put us on earth. God has not made us robots. Are you with me?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes, I want to be hearing that yes, to know you're not sleeping. God has not made us robots, but he has given us the free will to choose between what is right and what is wrong. You know why? So that we can rejoice. We can be strong. We can glorify his name. So that you say to yourself, thank God, I was able to overcome. I was determined. I prayed. I made effort. And he yielded some fruit. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
That's why there is joy in each time, in each and every one of us. Each time we struggle and we succeed. It's just like someone who is a chain smoker. Probably smokes a packet of cigarettes a day. And he begins to tell himself, I need to work on my smoking habit. And on the first day, he has determined to stop smoking. He buys a packet and he keeps smoking. But in his consciousness, he wants to limit his smoking. And by the time he's about to go to bed, there is one more stick remaining in the pack. He has started his struggles. Am I right?
Yes.
Because normally, by the time he goes to bed, no stick of cigarette will be remaining. So also with us from sin. If you know that which is the sin, which is the sin that is paramount in your life, this is a time to battle with it. A time of preparation. Christ is coming. Remember, the word of God says, nothing impure shall see the face of God. Nothing. But this is a time to prepare. Make the ways of the Lord straight and level. Begin now, not tomorrow. That is what the period of Advent is all about. So that we wouldn't be like the gatekeeper or the house servants who were ignorant, irresponsible. No, God has put us on this earth and has given us his free will, has given us his spirit to direct us on the path of eternity. And let us therefore be what? Watchful. You cannot tell a blind man to be watchful. Of what? Does he see anything? But we see. We have our consciences. And it's been formed by the Spirit of God. And God is beckoning on us, my brothers and sisters, to be watchful. Be watchful. No one knows when the Lord will come. When you die, your own Lord has come. Your own time has come. There is no repentance in hell or in heaven. So the Lord is asking us, my brothers and sisters, within these 4 weeks of Advent, let us prepare a highway for the Lord. And let me tell you something, my brothers and sisters. Sometimes Christians, some Christians complain, Father, I do not know. I'm struggling with this thing and I'm going down and I'm going back to it. I have resolved not to do this. And I see myself making mistakes. Often what I tell them is this. Do you see yourself making mistakes? Say, often they say, yes. I say, that is the beginning of your success. It might surprise you. Because it is only when you struggle that you can make a mistake. Am I right? That when you do not struggle, you cannot make a mistake. So, keep on struggling. You will keep making mistakes. At the time, mistakes will go, and you'll become a perfect human person. God doesn't want us to kill ourselves, but He wants us to daily, every day, day by day, gradually, to make efforts. Are you gradually making that effort? He says, no one knows when it will be. It's like a householder who is traveling. He entrusts everything to his household, his servants, and he leaves. He gets to the gate because he is very compassionate and he puts everyone into consideration. He gets to the gate. He even speaks to the gatekeeper. I am traveling. Be on your guard. Be watchful. Not only to look after my compound, but do what? Look after me on my arrival. God wants to come. He has not gone. He has not abandoned us. No, God does not abandon His children. But He has left us in charge of a whole wonderful thing. And He is trying and hoping that when He comes back, we will be alert and watchful. Let us pray, my brothers and sisters, that this period of Advent may bear us fruit, fruit for eternal life. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. We will rise and bring our needs to our loving Father.
For the church, that we might use this time of the holy season of Advent to prepare our hearts for the coming of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For world leaders, for an increased awareness that all power comes from above, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who feel abandoned and hopeless, that they may know the comfort of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who are facing difficult hardships in the winter months ahead, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, Alvin Kulak and James McConnell, that they will see the Lord above, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our heart, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
At this moment, to conclude our prayers of the faithful, we shall bless the Advent wreath, asking God in His mercy to remind us of the time of His coming. Lord God, Your church joyfully awaits the coming of its Savior, who enlightens our hearts and dispels the darkness of ignorance and sin. Pour forth Your blessings upon us as we light the candles of this wreath. May their light reflect the splendor of Christ, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise of his name, for our good and for the good of all his holy church.
Amen. Accept, we pray, O Lord, these offerings we make, gathered from among your gifts to us, and may what you grant us to celebrate devoutly here below gain for us the prize of eternal redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation. Now when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we, who watch for that day, may inherit the great promise, in which now we dare to hope. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles, his auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, St. Paul, St. John, St. Anthony, St. Matthew, St. Sixtus, St. Cornelius, St. Elizabeth, St. Cecilia, St. Veronica, St. Anne de Beaupré, St. Monica, St. Martha, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. And may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us call God Father in the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom of our glory is yours now.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace and joy of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share a sign of peace with each other.
Brothers and sisters, behold him, Jesus Christ, the one who has promised us eternal life, who is preparing a befitting place for us in heaven. He takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am worthy to enter your presence.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May these mysteries, O Lord, in which we have participated, profit us, we pray. For even now, as we work amid present things, you teach us by them to love the things of heaven and hold fast to what endures, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It's that time of year. All lectors, please pick up your lector's book from the vestry and sacristy after Mass. Your name should be on the book. Catholic daughters will be selling religious articles after all Masses. Sacred Heart Catholic School is hosting a breakfast with Santa in the parish hall on Sunday, December the 3rd. Tickets will be sold at the door. Everyone is welcome. This coming Friday is the Feast of the Immaculate Conception. Our celebration of the Feast of the Immaculate Conception Masses are Thursday, December the 7th at 7 p.m. and on Friday, December the 8th at 8:30 a.m. and 7 p.m. bilingual. The Mass for Our Lady of Guadalupe on Tuesday, December the 12th will be a bilingual Mass, will be at 7 p.m. All parishioners are invited. And there is a reception afterwards, but bring your favorite potluck dinner. You don't get away without coming for them. Now comes the next one. Parish Christmas party will be on Saturday, December the 16th. I believe that's 2 weeks from today. In the parish hall, after the 5 p.m. Mass. Guess what my next part of the announcement is? Please bring a dish. Do not forget the dish. This weekend is the weekend preparing for St. Vincent de Paul. So if you haven't wrapped your Christmas present, you took your card home, please go home and bring it because we need them here by Sunday, by Monday morning. So you better bring them back Sunday because, or you can come to 8:30 Mass on Monday and bring your gifts. Thank you.
Good evening to you all. Are we happy?
Yes.
Okay, good. I am happy. I just want to enlighten us about something. Our Lady is our mother, am I right?
Yes.
And she goes by a whole lot of names, right?
Yes.
Our Lady, Seat of Wisdom, Comforter of the Afflicted, Refuge of Sinners, Spiritual Vessel, Comforter of the Afflicted, Help of Christians, Morning Star, all Our Lady of Guadalupe, Our Lady of Fatima, am I right?
Yes.
But it is still that same Our Mother. It's my mother. I don't know about you, but you know, my mother, right?
Yeah.
Make it personal, and it will be personal. I mean, I don't play with her. But then, you know, sometimes people tend to particularize things in the church. And I just want to bring it to you. You know, when we celebrate Our Lady of Fatima, I don't think I've ever seen anybody say, no, leave it, it's not for us, it's for this, right? No. So why I'm saying this is that on the 12th of December, we shall be celebrating Our Lady of Guadalupe. It is not Our Lady of Mexico. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
It is not Our Lady of Spanish. It is still my mother and your mother, right?
Yes.
So it is the church's celebration. And above all, it is going to be our parish celebration. And I want to remove this concept that Our Lady of Guadalupe is a Spanish thing. It is not. I'm not a Spanish. It is my thing. Because she's still my mother. The church gives her these names based on where the apparition took place. Do you understand? If the apparition takes place somewhere in Lourdes, you can't say it's our Mother Mary's for the French people. Am I right?
Yes.
And then when we are celebrating Our Lady of Lourdes, you can't say, no, I'm not celebrating, it's for the Spanish. It's for the French. No. And above all, we are one family of Sacred Heart. Am I right?
Yes.
I want us to get integrated, to begin to know one another. This is the time to prepare. And I want you to put it in your preparation. For those who feel, well, this is no. In God's house, we are only one people. Just imagine yourself if God comes and that is the only thing holding you, what will you tell him? Nothing. He has created us in his own image and likeness. So on the 12th of December, we shall be celebrating Our Lady of Guadalupe. It is a parish activity, and I want us to celebrate it as one. And in the bulletins, you will see it is written Spanish Mass. It is not Spanish Mass. I told them yesterday to correct it, but it was already late. And that's why I asked them, put it out for me and let me talk about it. It's going to be a bilingual Mass, and everybody is invited. I don't need to invite you. You will come for Mass, right?
Yes,
so that is that. And then just to kind of let us know, the school there is our school. Am I right?
Yes.
And it bears our name, Sacred Heart. Let us patronize it in every form. And at this moment, the school is selling gift cards or asking us, this is the period when we buy cards for ourselves and for our friends and gift cards. If you are going online, it's there on the bulletin. In the bulletin, just look at it. Shop, whatever, but use our school code. The little revenue the school gets helps us not to close up, not to run down, but to always do what? Fund the school and be strong. Pay the teachers well and have quality education. We are maintaining in this school now, for those who do not know, a high standard of education. And I tell you, and it is showing in the exams. So be part of it. When you're talking about buying gift cards, come to the school or go online, buy and let us profit and continue to grow from strength to strength through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you very much, and God bless you. The Lord be with you. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessings. May the Almighty and merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessings. Amen.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity. Amen.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now and with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessings of the Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you both now and forevermore.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful night rest, and I wish you a fruitful advent.
Amen.